Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Tom and Arnold Talk Movies. I'm Tom. This is Arnold.
Hello.
Today, I'm going to be speaking about Possessor. This came out in 2020. It was written and directed by son of David Cronenberg, Brandon Cronenberg. This film follows Voss, who works for a shady company that uses mind control to perform assassinations. And the way they do this is, like, they implant a device in someone who's close to the target, and then someone goes in this case Voss, and she takes control of the possessed.
Yeah.
And performs the hit, and that's how they make their
Oh, I see. So they make them kill.
Yeah.
They're like puppets.
Yeah, okay. Basically. Brilliant film. Really did like this film. Brandon Cronenberg is similar to his dad
in terms of the style and imagery.
But I really did like this. There's some great, like, practical effect sequences, and just fucking brilliant, man. Brilliant. Technically looks fucking brilliant. Really good. It got that kind of 70s weird tech, like the machine
where a computer fills up a room, essentially.
Sort of that style. But they've got, like, the machine which they use to take control. It's like a big massive, like, helmet. And it's like it's not like sleek and like chrome.
No, it's just a big helmet
and, like, the buttons on the side of, like, the bed, because they have to the bed sort of thing. It's like the buttons are like something you'd see on the fucking Death Star.
So it's like tangible flashing light buttons.
No, sort of like that. Yeah. It's like, you know, like when you see the Death Star on the it's something like that. I don't think the story is as complicated as you think it's gonna be, and I don't mean that in sort of like what's the message of the film.
No,
I just mean it reminds me somewhat of like an Inception or a Christopher Nolan type film, where, like, there's this going on, but then there's actually this going on as well.
Yeah.
And there isn't, like, that third thing. It's just kind of, like, there's an assassination attempt which goes wrong, and it's the...
So it doesn't feel convoluted.
No. Although saying that, there is something to do with the main character of Voss, where she may be enjoying her job a bit too much, because you don't really see any other assassins, but the way the assassins usually work is a bit like they get a gun, bang,
it starts to become gratifying.
Whereas the way her methods in taking out people are like multiple stabbings and stuff like that. And there's also a thing, it's kind of like the Matrix, where, like, to leave no witnesses and to get out of the machine, you have to, like, shoot your puppet, essentially.
Yeah.
And she has a hard time shooting herself, which is another kind of thing.
Okay.
It's like she likes being in control, basically.
Yeah.
So there's something possibly there to do with whatever life's about. Chris Abbott's character is the person she eventually takes control of, and it's like the main sort of story. And, like, it's such a weird image. It's like, when I say she, I might put up a clip of Chris Abbott, who's obviously a man.
Yeah.
And, like, when I say she, I mean she as in her in control of the body.
Yeah.
So that's what I mean. But she sees these, like, weird, like, balls of fluff, and she grabs them, and then they disappear. And it's such a weird, like, she's obviously sort of hallucinating and she's not seeing it, but it's such a weird image. Like, it's just like, imagine just a floating ball, and it's like all crackling. It's like a Rice Krispie. And it's just like, it's just so weird, but it's just a really great sort of simple,
effective imagery.
Yeah, because it's just like, what the fuck, man? I do love the sort of design of this world as well, because it does feel like it takes place in sort of the near future, or maybe like an alternative world.
Does it feel like dystopian or something?
Yeah, because I'll tell you, because there's this... And this is another thing, though. I did like the film, but it feels like, what's the point in these details other than just to add
immersion?
Yeah. And it's like, not everything needs to be like...
No.
But when I think what I'm trying to say is, like, when it's specific to, like, the story, it feels like maybe there should have been more to that. Because when she takes control of Chris Abbott's character, she goes to his job, and it's a great, like, thing. But, like, he puts on this, like, VR headset, and he's in a room, like an office, and it's just like, in real life, he's in just a group of people, and it's kind of weird. Like, he's basically going into an office to put on his headset to go into another office, and what happens is, like, on his computer inside his VR set, he starts clicking through, like, random webcams. Like, what the fuck's going on? And he zooms in on the curtains. Like, what the fuck's going on? Turns out, yeah, which is, I thought was fucking great. This company is maybe hacking, but maybe they've been given permission to look into people's webcams and find out what their product preferences are. And it's kind of like, you know, the way all search engines and stuff like
very prevalent compared to today, instead of like, you know, cookies and stuff like that.
Yeah, and it gets very sort of weird because he sometimes stumbles on. See, I thought this was going to be like the third thing, but it never really went anywhere. Like, there's a bit where he opens a webcam and it's a couple having sex, and like, you're sort of like, what the fuck is going on? Like, is this some kind of weird sex dungeon place or something? But then he zooms in on a curtain and you're like, what the fuck, man? And then later on, they're having a chat and like, that's when you kind of find out what his job is and stuff like that. But again, it's a good little addition to the world and to find out what this place is like, but it doesn't really add anything apart from just being, oh, that's cool. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The sort of mind transference scene, though, is fucking brilliant to just fucking watch, man. It's just like, I sometimes wish I had...
Is it like psychedelic?
Yeah. It's fucking brilliant. Like, I sometimes wish I had like a fucking 500-foot fucking TV, man. Because like, there's like, you see her lying down and they must do like a quick cut and like her face just melts. And like it's obviously like they must have done a cheeky cut where they swap her with like a model, but it's a really detailed model. And what they do is they her whole body sort of melts and goes into like liquid, and then it reforms into the other character she's possessing.
Yeah, that's
and
sick.
It's fucking brilliant, man. And there's a few more sort of
and it's all practical, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks practical. There might be a bit of CGI, but there's other things as well, because I am kind of spoiling this, but like, it's better if I tell you, like, because there's moments where they start to sort of like, he starts to take control, then she starts to take control, and there's one moment where the mind, it to me, it's like the minds are like fighting each other.
Yeah.
And there's like a moment where like the two actors' faces have combined, and it's like some fucking grotesque monster thing. Fucking brilliant, man. Really fucking good, man. I fucking love that shit. Some keeps wearing though, but absolutely brilliant.
That's the passion talking.
Honestly, there. Really, really wise, man. Yeah, I'll sort of leave it there. It's a very, very good film, to be fair. I really did enjoy it. Brandon Cronenberg also did a film called Antiviral, which is fucking great as well, which is about, I think I've told you, it's like when they deal in viruses and they try to get a virus out.
Yeah, I remember you were saying.
Absolutely brilliant film. I don't know if he's done any more since Possessor.
Is he quite a relatively new filmmaker then?
Yeah, I mean, he's got the connection with David.
Oh, Cronenberg. Yeah, of course.
But in terms of his own film, I don't know how old he is. He's probably fucking younger than us. But
terrible.
Yeah. He's really good. Really, really glad I watched this one. Yeah, very good. Possessor. I watched it on Shudder. You might be able to watch it on Shudder too. So, yeah, and that'll do it for this video. So, thank you for watching. And... let's go fucking nuts.